guys, for example three, I want to take a look at a more complicated fraction, or at least more complicated than what we saw in example two. I want to simplify this. I want to put it into standard form. So there are a couple of ways to do this. You could, you know, I had mentioned before bunny ears or alien ears, the five into both of these. That's fine. I'm gonna start with simplifying the numerator, and then I'll worry about bunny earing my binomial up in the numerator. So here's what I mean by that. I'm gonna take this, and the first thing I see is the square root of the negative. So I know I'm gonna take the I out first. So this is gonna be equal to 15 minus I times the square root of 75 over 5. That's the first piece that I wanna address here. Now for 75, let me do a factor tree or break it down by primes. I'll put it off to the side here. So for 75, I know that can be, what, 3 times 25? And 25 is 5 and 5. So I see a pair of 5s and a 3. So this is going to be 15 minus I, and it looks like I have 5 squared times 3. And again, the way I'm approaching this particular write-up is I'm simplifying the numerator first. And then I'll bunny ears or alien ears the fraction. You could have alien eared the fraction first and then simplified the imaginary part of this expression. Okay, so I see you've got a pair of fives. It's gonna come out of the radical as a five. And again, the operation will be multiplication. So if I take a look at this, this is gonna be 15 minus 5i times the square root of 3 over 5. All right, now I need to get it in the form a plus bi. I've simplified the numerator all that I can. These are not like terms, so I can't add them. So now it is time to do my little alien ears. So this will become 15 over 5 minus, it looks like we have 5i root 3 over 5. 15 over 5 simplifies to 3. 5i root 3 over 5, the 5s are gonna cancel out. So this will be minus I root 3. Now this technically asked me to write it in the form a plus bi, so I could write this as 3 minus root 3 times I. So just to try and line these up, for this particular problem, a is the number 3, and b is the number negative square root of 3. So a plus bi, okay? And I've mentioned this in our examples, but it's always worth noting. So when working with negative radicands, do the I, or I should say, take out the I first, all right? You need to address the fact that you have an imaginary number first, and then use the other rules for radicals. So let me give you a compare and contrast of the correct way of handling a problem and the incorrect way. So if you look here, we're starting with the square root of negative 16 times the square root of negative 9. And I took the i's out first, right? I take the I out, square root of 16 is 4. Take the I out, square root of 9 is 3. And then 4 times 3 is 12, I times I is I squared, and we know I squared is negative 1. My answer is negative 12. And this is the correct answer. So if you don't do that, if you apply the rules for radicals first, if you say, well, this is an even index and this is an even index, so I can keep the even index but put the radicands together, you'll see here when you go negative 16 times negative 9, the negatives go away because a negative times a negative is a positive. And then you're going to tell me that the square root of 144 is 12. And you can see those are different answers. Let me scooch that up so we have enough room to see it. These are different answers. This is incorrect because it's lacking the negative here. This is correct. So you want to make sure, again, when you have negative radicands, take out the imaginary portion first, then use your other rules for radicals. All right, so with that, we're gonna move on to example four, and we're gonna plot a few of these complex numbers on the complex plane. I'll see you in a few, bye.